out from Flubber.
Hello, Al. I'm so full of bacon, my body's meant for shaking. And when I start to wiggle, my nipples, they will jiggle.
Once again, I have to be embarrassed for the both of us.
Yep.
Dad, you okay?
I'm fine, son. Just not a big fan of hospitals. Although they could dress it up with plants and pictures, but let's face it, this place is a slaughterhouse.
Cal! Mm-hmm. Dad, do you want to wait out in the car?
No, I'm okay. I'm fine. I'm on a beach. There's the surf. There's sand. There's needles. There's the horrible choking stench of hospital antiseptic.
Cal!
Coming.
This is Daddy's time with Reese.
Are you sure this is a good idea?
Dewey, I don't need you talking sense to me right now. Reese, quit screwing around!
Crazy! I can't eat!
Why? Is something bothering you at school, son? Oh, right.
Anybody want my baked potato? It's kind of burnt.
No, thanks. Reese, we aren't having baked potatoes.
Move! Mom will find us somehow.
No. I'm tired of running. I'm tired of screaming like a girl every 5 minutes. I will not be put out of my home by a bunch of airborne rodents, and neither will you. I may have been the one that brought them into this house, but it is up to all of us to show them the door. Get ready, boys. It's time to put out the bats.
Now, and we're pretty confident we can hide it from Dad.
Boys, listen, I'm gonna grab the TV and hide it till your mother gets back. I'm gonna tell Reese that it was stolen by junkies desperate for a quick fix. If he ever suspects, you didn't hear it from me. Oh, God.
Hey, Dad. The guy at the video store finally admitted they have a secret room behind the snuff films. I'm gonna go check it out.
Sounds like a plan. Boys, give me a hand here. Yeah. Oh, boys, help! No! Boys, help me! Oh, for God's sakes, what's wrong with you? Save your father's eyes! bags, but I'm the only one rinsing out baggies. I'm the only one splitting two-ply toilet paper. I'm the only one snacking out of bird feeders. Look at this. $18 for a 3-minute... What the...
Welcome to the hot fantasy sex line. What's your name, baby?
This is... Are you aware kids call these numbers? Put some clothes on! Oh.
Yeah, baby. Would you like that? Oh, you just love not responding, don't you? You're such a bad boy. Well, big spender, I can keep going as long as you can.
I've just spent the last half hour trying to explain to you people. You cannot charge me $800 for a phone call I never agreed to. This is wrong and unethical.
You're absolutely right, sir. We're bad.
What?
We've been very bad, and we need to be punished. What would you like to do to us?
I don't want to do anything to you!
Whatever you want, big boy. You're the one paying for this call.
No! No! Hi, yes, do you have a pair of Christian Louboutin's red open-toed slingback size 8.5? Not the knockoffs, the real thing. You do? Good. Now, I'm in a situation where money is no object, but how much? Oh! Oh, come on. Yes, yes, would you put a pair aside for me, please? Oh, what? Right. Yeah, it will make a nice surprise. That's our wallpaper, and that's the counter. Malcolm, their house doesn't look like this. This is our house. What is going on here?
Fine. I made it up because I'm sick of your insanity. I dummied up a phony web page to calm you down.
So you were gonna let me think that I was safe?
I wasn't gonna sit in the car with you all night. I'm sick.
I was protecting you.
From what, Dad? From ghosts? Well, I say bring them on. I hereby summon all ghosts and goblins.
No, 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 no.
Come phantoms and specters from the gates of hell. Thou art hereby invited.
He's kidding. That's the kind of language they respond to.
I challenge ye to prove me wrong. Go ahead, rip the skin from our bones and feast on our innards. We are lambs for your slaughter. Swallow this house into the bowels of hell.
Run! Run from this place and never return!
That guy was good.
Hey, survivor, huh? Guess you weren't around when Uncle Hal came a-knocking.
Oh, all right, let it go.
War's over.
All right! Knock it off! I mean it! Back off! I'm warning you! Your friends died like cowards!
I did one last week at work and everyone loved it!
Don't worry, Jamie. It's me he's after, not you.
You. Okay, let's stay calm. Not do anything stupid.
Eat wind, honeysucker!
Ha ha ha!
now.
Is everything okay?
Everything is just fine. Who's the idiot now? Oh my God, Jamie? How in the world did you get a hold of one of these? Do you have any idea what could happen if you play around with one of these? Look, see? This isn't a game. This is not a toy. Oh, your mother!
Stick him up.
Who wants a snack? There you go. All right. A little closer. Sorry, just a minor setback.
No, we're fine. Thank you for your trouble.
Wait, don't eat it without the fun.
Just leave.
Well, forgive me. I thought you might appreciate having some human interaction.
You're in here every 5 minutes when what we really need is rest. Hal, just go. Please, find something to do.
Finally.
Malcom, quit hogging the covers. You're just like your father in bed. We're on our own tonight. I thought maybe we'd go out to dinner.
Where are the kids?
Oh, Malcolm's over at Stevie's. Reese's got a hockey practice. Dewey's at Billy's, or one of the neighbor kids. So we're on our own. What are you in the mood for? That has got to be a new record.
You guys seen the remote for...
What's going on?
Dad, we've done something terrible. It might just be the worst thing we've ever done.
All right, just calm down. Let's talk this through. It can't be that bad. You've been stealing money from the church!
And maybe some merchandise.
Oh! Oh! Well, you boys have been taking stereos and toys! Is that cheese? Oh, I need to sit. Oh, my God.
Do we get a washcloth?
My boys are thieves.
Oh. Here, go, Dad. Nice and even. What's Mom gonna say?
Everything's ready. The kite-tail is set. It's a windy day. Now say it.
I am not cursed.
Good. Now run. And don't stop until it's in the air.
I am not cursed. I am not cursed. My wallet. Oh,
grocery list.
You know the drill. Mommy never knows. Hello there, Nell. Your eyes are very pretty.
Really? You like my eyes?
No! I was just told to say that. I'm sure you're very pretty, but I don't find you even remotely attractive. I was only flirting with you because my wife is making me.
Wait a minute. I was flirting with you, and the first thing you did was tell your wife?
I tell her everything.
And she told you to flirt back with me?
Yeah.
Just out of curiosity, how far was your wife willing to take this?
She wouldn't tell me!
Lois, I don't want to alarm you, but there is a naked man in your house!
Boys left for the prom a half an hour ago.
Yeah, I know. I got a flat tire on my way to Jamie's babysitter. I had to drive back on the rim.
There were a lot of sparks, but I don't think anything caught fire.
The main thing is that you and I have... Ah! Dewey! What are you doing here?
I live here.
Honey, Dewey's here!
What's he doing here?
Don't you have a prom to go to?
I'm not in high school.
He says he's not in high school.
Oh, for God's sake, Hal. We're just going to have to take a rain check.
No! Okay, look, I'm very sorry, but you gotta get out of here.
What? But I'm researching a history report online.
If it's money you want, you got it. Here, you ought to be able to have a good time with that. You can go to a movie, grab a burger. Hey, the Hyatt has a piano bar.
I don't have any shoes.
Buy some.
I love you, son.
Listen, maybe we'll go to the zoo sometime, huh? Just you and me.
You'll have to climb the ladder of achievement one rung at a time.
You'll never reach the top if you don't start climbing. And when you reach the top, you realize that the journey never ends.
Excuse me? If you're at the top, how come the journey doesn't end?
Because at the top of the ladder, there's a car. The question is, will you be driving? Or just a passenger. Whenever you let somebody else drive, well, he might have errands to do. Where do you think he might stop?
The dry cleaners?
Very good.
Where else?
Drugstore?
Yes. Where else? Tim?
There's a place you can go to have your shoes treated so they won't develop a smell over time.
Excellent. Okay, now. What does all this mean? It means nothing. It means nothing! This is what happens when you let somebody else drive the car. You've all got to be the drivers of your own car. And what do you do if the gas gauge says your tank is empty?
Stop at a gas station?
No! You keep driving! You don't let anything stop you. Let me hear some vroom!
Vroom!
You know!
Excuse me, Hal. I need to have a bathroom break.
Need? Or want?
I'd say need, Hal. I really have to go to the bathroom.
I need it. Just a break.
So this is something none of us feel we can overcome. This has us beat. Well then, we can put our work here aside and all go to the bathroom.
Only there's no bathroom in the car!